guys, I'm Priyanka. Welcome back to my channel. And I went to Shilparamam after a really, really long time. It's been years actually. I used to love shopping at Shilparamam. Now the prices have been hiked up quite a bit compared to earlier. So I don't go that often anymore, but still it's definitely worth visiting every once in a while. So if you're new to Hyderabad and if you haven't been to Shilparamam, then it's pretty much like Delhi Hat. So you'll see a lot of handicrafts and, you know, it's like a craft bazaar. If you're visiting from different cities, then this is one of those places that you definitely must visit. You'll find absolutely beautiful things for your home decor, for clothing, chappal, jutis, kolapuris. So you'll see ikat, kalamkari designs and, you know, different types of hand-printed and handmade things. And not to forget, you'll also find some stalls which sell western wear, which are all export rejects, similar to Sarojini, but the pricing is not like Sarojini. You'll not find dead cheap things. You can bargain quite a bit and bring them down to like 300 to 500. So I saw a lot of beautiful maxi dresses this time. Most of these stalls were quoting around 2200 for these Narayan Pet cotton maxi dresses. While the stitching seems pretty decent, I think a lot of boutiques also quote around 2500. If you can bargain, I think they'll give it for around 1600 or 1800. So there's a lot of margin on the sides. So even if you wear like XL or double XL, it'll still fit. So apart from this, you'll also see a lot of ikat prints and kalamkari prints, both in saris, dupattas and even dresses and kurtas. But this time I even spotted kalamkari printed jutis and footwear. You have to bargain in every stall quite a bit, probably start at half the price from what they quoted, because these days the prices have been crazy. You'll also see a lot of stalls carrying Lucknow kurtas and dupattas. Everything is very beautiful. So if you're looking for a chikankari kurta at an affordable price, this is one place you can definitely try. A lot of stalls have similar stocks, so you can actually check out few stalls and compare the prices before you purchase something. And moving on, we have a lot of Kashmiri stalls which sell stoles, accessories, and some of these stores even have home decor pieces. And a lot of places here have those beautiful bags with hand embroidery, and you'll also spot dupattas in hand embroidery and bandini dupattas. I also came across the stall this time which had phulkari dupattas. A lot of you guys keep asking about phulkari dupattas, so you'll find them here as well, and they're priced around 1500 to 1800. I think you can bargain and bring them down to about 1000 or 1200, depending on the quality and everything. They do have some dupattas even at the price range of 600 to 800. I leave the stall number here. You have to check out the stall. And also, stall numbers keep changing every once in a while, but these are the current stall numbers. Then moving on to accessories, there are a lot of stalls which carry junk jewelry and silver jewelry or artificial jewelry. And you'll also see Afghan jewelry, which is quite pricey. The prices go as steep as like 1800 to 2000 for these Afghan jewelry, and they're very difficult to bargain. For the normal accessories, they start from about 30 rupees or so. You can easily get earrings under 100 rupees, which are very beautiful. And you'll also see some meenakari earrings and a lot of different varieties. So these accessories are quite difficult to bargain these days, but you can get the basic neck pieces for about 200 to 300, while the Afghan pieces can go up really high. I tried to bargain quite a bit in some of these stores. So you'll have to spend a lot of time here bargaining. So that was a quick tour of all the stalls. Apart from this, you'll also see boating and some other interesting activities here. And during the festivals, they even have some stage performances. During festivals, you'll see a lot of local delicacies and some really yummy food. So this is open all throughout. I think they close for about 15 days sometime in December. I'm not really sure. You can check the website. I'll leave it in the description box. But otherwise, usually you can go from about in the afternoon, and it is open till around 8 o'clock in the night. Now coming to the haul, so I'm going to divide this video into two parts. I'm going to be showing you the western wear which I got in this video, and rest of the haul will be on my Telugu channel before someone bashes me about not doing videos in Telugu. So here is the thing, I have a Telugu channel. It goes by my name, Priyanka Boppana Telugu, and there's a lot of people in Hyderabad who don't understand Telugu or who don't speak Telugu, so that's the reason I have two channels. So in Telugu lo kuda videos chestunanu, akkada kuda active ga post chestunanu. Me Telugu channel కి కూడా వెళ్ళి సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోండి. అది ప్రియాంక బొప్పన తెలుగు అని ఉంటుంది. నేను లింక్ ఇంకా డిస్క్రిప్షన్ బాక్స్ లో కూడా పెడతాను. సో నౌ లెట్స్ గెట్ స్టార్టెడ్ విత్ ద హాల్. సో ఐ పిక్డ్ అప్ సమ్ వెస్టర్న్ వేర్ ఫ్రమ్ వన్ పర్టికులర్ స్టాల్. ఐ లీవ్ ద స్టాల్ నంబర్ హియర్. యూజువల్లీ ఐ హావ్ లైక్ 2-3 స్టాల్స్ విచ్ ఐ గో అండ్ పిక్ అప్ స్టఫ్ ఫ్రమ్, బట్ this time I found only one person. And the prices can really vary. They quote about 750. Most of the stalls, not just the stall. I spotted some really good pieces this time. Tops can start from about 200 for smaller tops. In spaghetti strap tops or, you know, smaller shirts and everything can come for like 200 rupees to 250 rupees, while bigger sizes or like longer dresses can cost about 400 to 500. So most of these stalls would quote about 600-700 or even 800 per pieces, but you'd have to bargain quite a bit. Depends on how you bargain and, you know, how much time you spend with this shopkeeper actually bargaining and requesting. Getting a good amount of pieces from one particular store always helps with bargaining. I'm sharing all this information because a lot of you guys keep asking. So this is what I got. So I'll quickly show you guys everything that I got. And these sizes can actually vary. Pieces can actually come in different sizes at times, but sometimes you'll find only one piece in each size. This is the first thing that I wanted to show you guys. It's a denim dress and it's a midi length dress, and as you can see, the quality is good. I have something similar from Westside actually, which is sleeveless. If you guys have seen it in some other videos, it has polka dots and the quality is the same. You'll find a similar quality in like stores like Westside or even stores like H&M. It's a good quality and it's a little bit loose, and the waist actually, the line waistline here drops a little bit down, so I might have to alter it a little bit or wear a belt, but otherwise it looks really good. It can be worn even as a jacket or a shrug. I quite like this piece and I think it's a very good quality one. So if you're looking for like casual wear for college or even just regular use, then these are some stalls you can definitely find good pieces from. We had to bargain quite a bit, but it really depends on these people's mood also that day, I think. So this is the next one. This is a maxi dress and I really like this print. I think it's perfect for like beach holiday, and I think otherwise also it can be worn because the color looks so beautiful. It would look really good in pictures. And this one for a change is not loose. Sometimes in Shilparamam I find like really big sizes, or I just don't find my size. So yeah, this one is actually a good fit and I like the quality. This is the next dress which I picked up. This is also a maxi dress and it has that crushed material, and this is what the detailing looks like near the neck. And this one's a little big. I have to get it altered, but I quite like the flow that the dress has. So this is what it looks like. Again, this is something nice that you can wear on vacations and the color would look really beautiful pictures. And there's one more piece which I think went for wash. It has cycle print all over it and it's like a short dress. I can wear it over leggings like a kurta or like a dress, or I can totally wear it as a dress. So overall I think I paid around 1800. So it really depends. You can bargain quite a bit and, you know, he might reduce the price furthermore, or sometimes they just don't. So it really depends on how you bargain, and if you're a regular visitor also they tend to reduce the prices quite a bit. So that was it for the Western wear. Now I actually got a lot of things from Indian wear too. So you can check out that haul on my Telugu channel. Nenu dresses and sarees teeskunanu meena Telugu channel meeda chudochu. Priyanka Boppana Telugu ani ikkada channel peru pedtanu. So head to my channel and watch the rest of the haul. So I hope this video was fun. Let me know in the comments below what other places you would like me to explore, and I'll leave these stall numbers and everything in the description box too. You can actually see them on the screen. I'll probably put them on the screen. And before you go, don't forget to subscribe. I keep uploading every week. I upload twice every week and I keep exploring local markets and I bring in a lot of affordable fashion looks and hauls and even reviews. So do check out everything. I have a whole series on my channel where I explore street shopping places in Hyderabad and other cities too. So do check out those videos, and I leave my Instagram handle here. You can see quick updates there. So as and when I see sales or when I actually go street shopping, I keep posting IGTV videos or Instagram stories. So do find me on Instagram too, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.